Hundreds took to the streets of Amman, Jordan, and Beirut in Lebanon in solidarity with Palestinians massacred in Gaza. Protesters waved flags and carried signs reading "Ceasefire Now." Pro-Palestine protests were also held in Pakistan, Turkey, and Iraq, all calling for an end to the war. Now in Tel Aviv, hundreds of Hamas hostages, or friends rather, of Hamas hostages who remain in Gaza organized a dance class in her honor at the hostage square. Romy Gonen was seized on October 7 in a festival in southern Israel. The dangers called for the release of all hostages and an end to the war. No end in sight for the war in the Middle East. At the stroke of midnight, rockets fired from Gaza illuminated the night sky. This triggered sirens throughout central and southern Israel. But the rockets were intercepted by its Iron Dome. There were no reports of any direct hits. The Hamas militant group's armed wing said the barrage was in response to massacres against civilians in Gaza. Israel set to pull out thousands of troops in Gaza. The Israeli army says troops from five brigades will be returning to Israel, allowing reservists to return to their jobs to help boost the country's economy. It will also allow standing army troops to train to become commanders as Israel anticipates a long war ahead. Israel continues its all-out offensive in Gaza as it intensifies attacks on the central part of the enclave. Gaza closed the year with nearly 22,000 Palestinians killed in the war. Yemen's Houthi group says 10 of their naval personnel were killed in an attack by U.S. forces in the Red Sea. U.S. naval helicopters sank three of the four small boats of the group as part of its patrol mission to counter threats from rebels. But the militant group claims the boats were there to prevent Israel's ships from entering Palestine's ports. Amid Israel's war on Gaza, Houthis have repeatedly targeted vessels in the Red Sea, which they believe are linked to Israel. This pushed major global shipping companies to abandon the waterway. Russia confirms attacks on military facilities in the Ukrainian city of Kharkiv overnight. This in response to Ukraine strikes on Belgorod the previous day. Among the targets, the former Kharkiv Palace Hotel and the headquarters of the Ukrainian Security Service for the Kharkiv region. Moscow says military and intelligence officers involved in the Ukraine attack or in the attack by Ukraine had been among those killed, along with what it claims are foreign mercenaries and militants. Several waves of Russian drones also hit residential buildings as part of a wider bombardment of Ukraine. Both sides have increased attacks in the last week of 2023, with Russia launching its biggest air assault of the 22-month war on Ukraine on Friday. Meanwhile, in his New Year's message, Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky said the country has become stronger as the war moves towards its second year.
Everyone has something to smile about because it worked out. And everyone has something to cry over because of losses. Each of us fought, worked, waited, helped, lived, and hoped this year in our own way. Everyone, but everyone will find something common to all Ukrainians this year. The major result of this year, its main achievement, Ukraine has become stronger. Ukrainians grew stronger. Ukraine is alive. Ukraine lives. Ukraine fights. Ukraine advances. Ukraine overcomes the path. Ukraine gains. Ukraine works. Ukraine exists. And altogether, this is not a New Year's miracle, not a fairy tale, not magic, but the merit of each of you.
Denmark's Queen Margrethe II announces a surprise abdication after more than five decades on the throne. The 83-year-old queen made the announcement in her traditional New Year's Eve speech live on TV. Now, she said a back surgery in February 2023 gave her thoughts about the future. She adds, "This is now the right time to pass the responsibility to the next generation." The Danish queen will hand over the reins to her son, Crown Prince Frederick, on January 14, after exactly 52 years on the throne. North Korea no longer seeking reconciliation and reunification with South Korea. That declaration from leader Kim Jong-un, as reported by state media KCNA. Kim said inter-Korean relations have become hostile and it is time to acknowledge the reality and clarify its relationship with the South. He added if Washington and Seoul were to attempt military confrontation with Pyongyang, its nuclear war deterrent will not hesitate to take action. The leader of the reclusive nation also vowed to put three new military spy satellites into orbit this year.